The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity. And when it is God's will, for the procreation of children and their nurture in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this holy union, Edward Sisson and Kevin Erbe now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not lawfully be married, speak now, or else forever hold your peace. I require and charge you both here in the presence of God that if either of you know any reason why you may not be united in marriage lawfully and in accordance with God's word, you do now confess it. Kevin, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Edward, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Will all of you witnessing these promises do all in your power to uphold these persons in their marriage? If so, answer, we will.
We will.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Let us pray. O gracious and ever-living God, you have created us male and female in your image. Look mercifully upon this man and this woman who come to you seeking your blessing, and assist them with your grace, that with true fidelity and steadfast love, they may honor and keep the promises and vows they make, through Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated for the readings.
Over there.
A reading from the Song of Solomon. The voice of my beloved. Behold, he comes leaping upon the mountains, bounding over the hills. My beloved is like a gazelle or young stag. Behold, there he stands behind our wall, gazing at the window, looking through the lattice. My beloved speaks to me. Arise, my love, my fair one, and come away. For lo, the winter is past, the rain is over and gone. The flower appeared on earth, and time singing has come.